Hello. This tutorial is designed to describe to you what a genome browser is. We're looking here at a genome browser in a database called ToxoDB. And a genome browser is basically a web interface that allows you to browse a genome. Now, I know this sounds complicated, but really it's a very simple concept. Imagine Google Maps, and everybody probably has used Google Maps. Google Maps is basically a browser of maps. It's a map browser. And using Google Maps, you can look at continents, you can look at states, cities, you can zoom in to street level as well. The same thing with the genome browser. Instead of looking at maps, you're looking at a genome for a particular organism. For example, you can look at the genome of human beings in a genome browser. In this case, we're looking at the genome of an organism called Toxoplasma gondii. But the organism is really irrelevant here. The point is that this is a genome browser that allows you to browse and walk around and do different things with a genome in a browsing manner, just like you would browse maps and cities and streets using Google Maps. Okay, so going down this page here, you will notice right at the top here, it says ToxoDB GBrowse version 2.48. It's a 40 kilobase pair region from TGME49, and there's a bunch of numbers here. So let's walk you through this. So ToxoDB is a database. GBrowse is this particular genome browser. There are many different versions, just like there's Google Maps, there's MapQuest, there's Apple Maps. This is GBrowse, which is developed by a group called the GMod Consortium. And this is the version of the software, which may be important for certain applications. 40 kilobase pairs tells you something about the size of the area you're looking at. It's almost like the distance on a map or the size of a geographic area you're looking at. So kilobases is 1,000 base pairs. And as you know, nucleotides are measured in the number of nucleotides or base pairs. So 10 base pairs is 10 nucleotides and so forth. So 40,000 base pairs is an area of essentially 40,000 nucleotides that you're looking at. And these 40,000 nucleotides are coming from this organism, TGME49, Toxoplasma gondii. ME49 is just a strain of the parasite. And then here is the actual coordinates. This is just like GPS coordinates on a map. So CHR stands for chromosome. V1 is Roman numerals for 6. So this is chromosome 6. And we are located between nucleotides 435,135 and 475,134. So if we scroll down, we can slowly look at this genome browser, and you will see here at the top that there are different tabs. There's a tab for the browser itself, which is what we're looking at. There's a tab for selecting tracks, and then there are a number of other tracks which we won't discuss today. So moving down, you will notice here that there's a landmark or region section, and this is just like, you'll notice here that this has the exact coordinates that are listed on the top here. So this is where you can put your genome GPS coordinates. Just like in Google Maps, you can actually use GPS coordinates to pinpoint a specific city or a specific house even. Here you can put in specific coordinates for the genome. And so we're looking right now, as I mentioned before, at the Toxoplasma gondii ME49, chromosome 6, and this is the area we're looking at. We can actually change this, and so let's look at chromosome 5. Since there's chromosome 6, there must be a chromosome 5. So let's go ahead and delete the 1 and click on search. And this page will reload. And now you'll notice that it tells us essentially the same stuff up here. We're still looking at a 40 kilobase pair region, but now we're looking at chromosome 5. And we didn't change the actual numbering of the location of this 40 kilobase pair. So we're essentially at the 400,000th nucleotide on chromosome 5. However, some things changed. Obviously, we're on a different chromosome, and if you were paying attention before, you can always go back, but you'll notice that the genes here, these little stick models over here are actually representing genes that are what's called annotated on the genome. Basically, you can look through a string of nucleotides and you can define exactly where genes are present. And once you define where they are, you can draw them mapped back to this. So you can imagine that, so just like in Google Maps, you can layer on data like traffic or where movie theaters or restaurants. You know, these genes are basically one of those data points. So imagine the genes are just data points for house numbers or for different houses. So as you change this, these numbers, if you zoom in or zoom out, you will see more or less genes in a particular view. So let's go ahead and try that. So let's go ahead and zoom out. So you can zoom out in different ways, but I'm going to try it just right here. So I'm going to zoom out to 50 kilobases, or let's do 100. So let's zoom out to 100 kilobases. So this is going to reload. And so now, instead of looking at 40 kilobase pairs, we're looking at 100 kilobase pair region. And you'll notice here that there are many more genes in this region, which makes more sense. We're looking at a larger piece of DNA, and more than likely it'll include many more genes. Okay, so moving down the Genome Browser, you'll notice there's three sections here, one called Overview, one called the Region, and one called the Details. The Overview shows you the entire chromosome that we're looking at. Okay, so organisms that have multiple chromosomes would have multiple chromosomes, obviously. So this is chromosome 5 in this particular organism. And so the Overview shows you the entire chromosome with a highlighted region of the 100 kilobase pair region or size or area that we're looking at. So this is like looking at a map of the United States with Pennsylvania highlighted. So we're looking simply at this region. This now is the region section actually shows you a slightly zoomed in area around our highlighted area. So you see that this is has more numbers, there's more resolution here. And now your highlighted region looks bigger. And then finally, the details region includes the exact 100 kilobase pairs that are found between these nucleotides. And so this region here from the two arrows pointing outwards are the actual, the exact region that we're looking at. Now, one thing about the numbering system here, so note that the chromosome starts at 0 and ends at something like 3.5 million nucleotides. And so this number is really arbitrary. It's based on just lining up the nucleotides, and you have to start somewhere. So you give the first nucleotide a number 1 or number 0, and then the last nucleotide would be whatever number it is. And like I said, this is arbitrary, so which means that if we had started the sequence from the other end, then 0 would be actually the last nucleotide, and the last nucleotide would be the first nucleotide. So just something to keep in mind, that we're just looking at things relative to how this chromosome was numbered. And so all of these genes that are displayed here are going in different directions. You'll notice blue ones, they go from left to right, and that's in relation to actually the numbering, how this chromosome was numbered. And then you have red genes, and those are going from right to left. But if you flip this chromosome around, obviously the red ones become blue and the blue ones become red. So it's really relative to the direction of the particular chromosome. Okay, each of these genes, if you'll notice, there are some interesting features about them. So they're not solid lines. So one of them here, this one is a solid line. Okay, and so this means that this is a single exon gene. Remember, genes can be made up of multiple exons, depending on the organism you're looking at. And so in this case, this is a gene that has a single exon. And when you mouse over it, you'll get additional information, including the organism and species it comes from, the gene ID. So each gene gets its own specific ID. So just like houses have their own numbers and a zip code to identify them, so each gene will have a specific ID. There's something about the gene type. This is protein coding, and genes, if you know what they do, you give them a description. In this case, it's not known what it does, so it's called hypothetical. And then there are many other additional information available here in the mouse over. We can take a look at this gene, for example, this red one right here. You'll notice it has many little boxes attached by lines. So this means this is a multi-exon gene. And so this one in particular has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, about 8 exons. Okay, so this is an 8-exon gene. And when you look at the description here, you'll notice that the coding sequence, so CDS stands for coding sequence, that's the sequence that will make a protein, the protein part of the gene, has multiple sections. Each section refers to a different exon. Okay, so in addition to seeing the genes that are layered on a chromosome, the Genome Browser allows you to load many other data types. Remember, I said it's just like Google Maps, where you can load information about traffic, you can load information about restaurants, about movie theaters, maybe something about parks and neighborhoods and so forth. The same thing with a Genome Browser, you can layer a lot of different types of data points onto a particular region you're looking at or at a whole chromosome. And you do this by going to the Select Tracks section. And so I'm going to click on this Select Tracks tab. And now you'll notice here we have many options. These are all different categories. And if you expand these, you'll see that there's a lot of information popping up here. And So again, don't get bogged down by the amount of information that's available. That's something you can learn as you learn about biology. But let's go ahead and, for the sake of showing this, I'm going to go ahead and load a track for RNA sequence data. And so I'm going to click on this particular track. And once you click on it, you'll notice on the upper left-hand side, you'll have a wheel, which indicates something is loading. And now if we go back to the browser, what you will notice now, all of a sudden, there's a new track showing up here. And you'll see this is just a graph, right? It's a graph of data that's mapped to the same area of the chromosome where all of our genes are. And so you can use a little ruler here, and you can actually move it up and down, and you'll see that the number up here is changing. So that's indicating the exact nucleotide. So if you're interested in knowing, for example, for this 2-exon gene, if you want to know where do the peaks coincide with, you'll notice here that this exon has a bunch of RNA sequence, a peak of RNA sequence, and it goes down where the intron is, and then it goes up again where the other exon is. Okay, so that's a nice way of actually looking at this. Take this out of the way. You can, as I mentioned, you can zoom in and out. So just like in Google Maps, you can click on this and you can zoom out to, let's say, 1 megabase pair region. Another way of doing this is you can actually highlight an entire section of a chromosome and then zoom into it. And so now I'm going to zoom into almost over a million nucleotides of sequence. And what you'll notice here is that everything gets more packed, right? So there are tons of genes in this region, and your graph becomes almost hard to read, but you can clearly see there are peaks and troughs in this graph. Okay, so I think I'll end here. Again, just make sure you play around with this. You can't really break anything. Load different tracks and zoom in and zoom out, and it should be hopefully as interesting as looking at Google Maps, but looking at chromosomes instead.